Today we discuss the controllers. Basically, these controllers are used for implementing system performance. That means the system response. If we have some problem in the response, that is, we can consider one system. Let us say this is the response of the system. So in this case, we are getting the overshoot like this. So this is the peak overshoot, and since the peak overshoot is large, so it is taking so much time to reach into the steady state. Let us say this is the granular, which can be considered as for the stability. So if it is going here, then after this particular time period, it is entering into the steady state. So to improve the system, that means to reduce this peak overshoot. If you reduce the peak overshoot, it will reach to the steady state faster, right? So for controlling of these transients, we will have to make some extra circuit connections inside the control system, and that particular circuit is called as controllers. So we will see what are the types of controllers. Basically, all the control systems are proportional in nature, right? And there are the controllers like derivative controllers, integral controller, and the combination of these two, that is integral and derivative. And since, as I have said, that proportional is always there, so it will be PI, that is proportional and integral, it will be PD, that is proportional and derivative. And third one is, if you want to improve the complete whole system, then we will have to go for the PID. We have discussed about this for the transients, right? So this is one thing that we need to improve, that means we need to reduce this particular peak overshoot. Along with that, we will also have to improve the steady state error. Like, if this is the required one, and if we are getting this result, then we can say that this is the steady state error. So we will have to improve this error by adding one type of controller, which is called as integral controller. So that means if we add the integral controller along with the proportional control system, then it will reduce this ESS. And that is why we can say that steady state error is improved, or we can say the response of steady state is improved. And if we add proportional derivative along with integral, then it will take care of this transients as well as steady state. So we'll take example, we'll see the response. Let's say this is the required one, that is R of T, and here I can make two circuit to make two response. Let us say these two response, where you can say this is C1 of T. When this is system one response, C1 of T corresponds to the response of system first, and this is C2 of T, that means this is the response of system second. Now, if you see the transient response, then the transient response of system 2 is better than that of system 1, because the peak overshoot is less as compared to that of the C1T. And not only that, but also the settling time is less. Settling time, we know that it is a time required to enter the steady state condition. So for this particular system, that is system 2, it is reaching to the steady state very soon. Let us consider this as ideal case. Instead of analog, we will use this as an ideal. So this is TS2, that is the settling time of system 2, and here we are getting the settlement of system 1, so we call this as TS1. So in this case, what is happening? This TS1 is larger than TS2. That means system 1 is taking more time to reach into the steady state as compared to the system 1. This is a relative state. System 2, sir. So in this case, along with the peak overshoot, if we compare this, then we find that the peak overshoot of system 2 output response is better than as compared to that of the C1T, that is response of the system 1. Here, the time is for that setting time of system 2 is less than setting time of system 1. That means system 2 is overall, it is better than, rating is better than system 1. So now, we know that the peak overshoot NP, this is given as e raised to power minus pi zeta over under root of 1 minus zeta square. So from here, we can say that this peak overshoot is inversely proportional to zeta. That means, if we increase the zeta, we will find there is a decrease in peak overshoot. So here, we have this particular term zeta, which will be taken care by adding some controller into the system. Means we will try to increase this zeta by adding some more control circuit inside the control system to reduce this peak overshoot, that will take care of this operation. And we also know, from here we can say that as zeta increases, NP decreases. Similarly, we know that setting time TS is given as 4 over zeta omega n. So again, in this case, setting time TS is proportional to 1 over zeta. So if zeta is increasing, we'll find there is a decreasing settling time TS. So here we can say that as zeta increases, settling time decreases. So if from both the cases, we can see that the parameter zeta is the fact, is the damping factor which has to be increased by adding the controller so that it will take care of the transient response. It will improve the transient response. So here we can say that the improvement in transient response means reduction in the peak overshoot as well as in the setting time. And this can be achieved by increasing the value of damping ratio, that is zeta. Now, we will draw another response. This is R of T. Now let us make this C2 of T with some ESS. We'll use some ESS over here. Then this is system 1. So here you can say that this particular is ESS 2, that is steady state error 2. Here it is with this particular point. This is ESS 1. So in this case, ESS 1 is greater than ESS 2. We can say this is C1 of T. This is C2 of T. So again, we are taking the same example that the performance of system 2 is better than the performance of system 1. So we have already seen for the transient response. This is the transient response. Now we are taking care of the steady state response. So in steady state response, we can see this steady state error ESS. So here, this ESS 2 is the steady state error for the system 2, and this is ESS 1, which is the steady state error for the system 1. So in this case, if we compare this, we'll find that ESS 1 is greater than ESS 2. That means the steady state error in system 1 is more. That means it is away from the required result. And relatively, we can say that ESS 2 is less than ESS 1, that means system 2 is very close to the required result. So in overall case, if you consider this figure as well as the earlier one, we will say that system 2 response, that is consisting of transient response as well as the steady state response, is better than that of the system 1. Now we will see one standard second order system, and we will try to apply this type of different types of controllers, that is derivative controller and the integral controller, for the betterment or the improvement in the performance of the system. That means to improve the transient response as well as the steady state response. So we'll see the standard second order system. We'll use this as Liouville block, which will work for the proportionality. This is S, S plus 2 zeta omega n. here you have this C of S, and we use it as unity feedback system. So this is unity feedback negative system, negative, and this is positive. Now for the improvement in transient response, following are the controllers which can be used. This is for improvement in transient response, and we know that for improvement in transient response we have to increase this value of zeta so that it can reduce the peak overshoot NP as well as the second time TS. So first of all we will see this improvement in transient response, and for this we will have to use the following controllers, and this control along with the proportion. Of course the controllers are used, means types of controllers along with proportional, and we know that each and every control system has a proportional control. So the first one is derivative error controller. This is also called as error rate control scheme. So this is the first type of controller for the improvement in transient response, that is derivative error controller, or this can also be called as error rate control system. And the second one is derivative output control, or we can call it as tachometer feedback control, or we can call it as output rate control. These are the name of same system. This is derivative output control, or tachometer feedback control, or output rate control. The name itself suggests that in this case we have to take the derivation of error. That means we are going to control the error signal by taking the derivative of it, and we are going to add this with the proportional signal. And in the second one, that is derivative output control, or tachometer feedback control, or output rate control, that means in this case we are going to take care of the output. Since feedback is involved, that means we are going to take the derivative of output, and that will be added along with the proportional signal to control this plan. Basically, when we talk about the controlling, what is happening? The signal which is input to this plant, that is proportional to the error signal. So here, if we say this standard second order system, this is B of S and this is E of S, that is error signal. So in this case, what is happening? Since this is standard second order system without any control, we can call this as uncompensated system. And for the uncompensated system, the signal that is over here, let us say this star is the signal to this plant, which has the gain of omega n square over s multiplied by s plus 2 zeta over n. So the gain over here, this is proportional to the error signal. That is why we are using this one as this block as a unity gain block, so that it will show that the signal which is input to the plant is proportional to the error signal. So now, for this two methodology, where we are going to use the derivative error controller and the derivative output controller, we are going to use this error, derivation of error and the derivation of output along with this proportionality. That means, for this derivative error controller, the signal which is applied as input to the plant, that should be the combination of error signal E of S and the derivative of error signal E of S. That is, it is going to be something like this, and that will be added, that will be given as input to the system. In the second part, where we have the derivative output control, or the tachometer feedback control, or the output rate control, in this case, we are going to add the derivation of output system, that is C of S, along with this proportional signal E of S, and the combination of these two will be given as input to the plant. And the system in which we are using this derivative along with the proportional is called as PD controller. This is PD controller. Now we'll see the operation. For this, we can write the characteristic equation of uncompensated system. This is given as s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square equals to 0. Now, in derivative error control, basically, in this case, the input signal to the plant is the combination of error signal and the derivative of error signal. And the control action will be defined as the control action is defined as Vc of t equals to E of t plus Kd ddt of E of t. Basically, this asterisk or the star is Vc of t. So this is the signal which is used for controlling of this plant. So in this case, in the standard one, Vc of t is equal to E of s. There is no derivation part. But now, since we are going to use this derivative error control along with this proportional, the control action will be defined as, this will be defined as the combination of two signals. One is the error signal and second one is the derivative of error signal. So this equation becomes Vc of t equals to E of t plus Kd ddt of E of t, where Kd is derivative constant. So we take the Laplace transform. If we take the Laplace transform, it will give us Vc of s equals to E of s plus Kd s E of s. So we take this E of s outside. So Vc of s, that becomes E of s multiplied by 1 plus Kd s or s Kd, whatever you write. Now we try to draw the new block diagram of this particular system along with the proportional and along with the derivative control in addition to the proportional. Now we draw the compensated system, the system where we have compensated the problem of the transient response or the problem of the transient response, that is called as a compensated system where we can use this control action. Now the derivative control system will be that is PD system. We are taking our PD system or the PD controller. That is having proportional and derivative. So here we have RS, that remains as it is, there is no issue. Here you will have E of S, here we can use a block of unity. But now in this case, what is happening? The Vc of S, that is basically the combination of two signals, one is E of s and second one is the derivative of E of s. So it will be like this, and we have this gain as skd or kds, whatever you can write, and we will have this as addition. So in this case, now control action is Vc of s, that is equals to E of s plus skd E of s. So this is the term, and here we can use that omega n square over s plus 2 zeta omega n. So this output is C of S and the feedback is unity. This is one. This is the, so basically, this is the compensated system. This is the compensated system where we have the control action as Vc of S equals to E of S plus Kd S E of S. So this is the block diagram we are going to use. And we will see that how this particular compensated system is going to improve the transient response. For that, now we write the transfer function, that is C of S over R of S. This is given as omega n square 1 plus SKD divided by S times of S plus 2 zeta omega n plus omega n square 1 plus SKD. Basically this is 1 plus SKT. So it is omega n square over 1 plus SKD multiplied by s plus 2 zeta omega n square, and you can add this term omega n square with 1 plus skd in this particular term. So this is the transfer function. So from here we can write the characteristic equation. For that we can elaborate this. So this can be written as omega n square 1 plus skd, that is divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n plus omega n square kd. These are common for S term, this plus omega n square. So from here, you can write the characteristic equation of compensated system. So the characteristic equation of compensated system is S square plus 2 zeta omega n plus omega n square kd, S plus omega n square equals to 0. So this is the characteristic of compensated system. Now let us consider that the damping factor for the compensated system is zeta 1. This is the damping factor of compensated system. Here we are considering that zeta 1 is the damping factor of compensated system. So now we will write this characteristic equation again in the form of standard second order system with a damping factor zeta 1. So here the characteristic equation can be written as S square plus 2 zeta 1 omega n s plus omega n square equals to 0, where we can say that 2 zeta 1 omega n is equals to this particular term, that is 2 zeta omega n plus omega n square kd. So from here we can obtain the expression for zeta 1, which is equals to 2 zeta plus kd omega n over 2. That means zeta 1 is going to be zeta plus kd omega n divided by 2. So now in this expression, zeta 1 is equals to zeta plus kd omega n over 2. So in this case, what is happening? This zeta is basically the damping factor of uncompensated system. So the compensated damping factor is going to be increased by the factor kd omega n by 2. That means the zeta 1 is greater than zeta by the factor kd omega n 2. So this is going to be added along with this zeta. So here we can say that zeta 1 is greater than zeta. And since zeta 1 is greater than zeta, what is happening? Since MP is proportional, inversely proportional to 1 over zeta. So since zeta is increasing, MP will decrease. And TS is also inversely proportional to zeta. So as zeta increases, TS decreases, and hence we can say that there is an improvement in the transient response. So this is the way how we use the derivative error control for controlling of the transient response. Now we'll see the next one, that is the derivative output control.
Here we have R of S, the output is E of S.
So in this case, we are going to compare E of x. So I am removing this one unit block over here because that is proportional. And here we have the derivative. Of course, this signal is given as input to the omega n square over s times of s plus 2 zeta omega n. Here we have C of s. The block is available over here, that is s times of kt. We will write this as skt with a negative sign. And here we have the unity feedback. So this is wall negative. So this is the compensated system where we are going to compare the derivative of output system, output signal with the error signal, and the difference between these two, that is the comparative output of these two, will be given as input to the plant. So this is called as derivative output control or output rate control or tachometer feedback control system. So now we'll analyze this system. We can write the characteristic equation. After solving this, we can have the characteristic for the compensated system as s square plus 2 zeta omega n plus kt omega n square times of s plus omega n square equals to 0. So now again we will write this in terms of standard second order system. Let us consider zeta 1 is a damping factor. This is the damping factor or damping ratio of compensated system. So here we can write this as s square plus 2 zeta 1 omega n s plus omega n square equals to 0, where we can say that zeta 1 is equals to this complete term, that is 2 times of zeta omega n plus kt omega n square. So now we will find what is the value of the zeta 1. So here we can have the zeta 1 as 2 times of zeta plus kt omega n divided by 2. Plus in this case, this 2 zeta omega 1 so here this is zeta 1, we can write here 2 zeta 1 omega n 1 equals to this term. So where 2 zeta 1 omega n is equals to this particular term, 2 zeta omega n plus kt omega n square. So if we solve this, we can have this value of zeta. So we can say that zeta 1 is going to be zeta plus kt omega n by 2. So again in this case zeta is increasing. Since zeta is increasing, again the same case, we know that mp is inversely proportional to zeta. So since by using the controller in this particular system, as zeta increases, this mp decreases. Along with this, we can say that ts is inversely proportional to zeta. So as zeta increases, ts also decreases. Hence, there is improvement in the system and the transient response is improved. So these are the two methods for the improvement in the transient response. Now the next, we will see how to improve the steady state by using the integral control scheme. Now third one is integral control scheme, or we can say this as integral controller. And the control in which we have this proportional along with this integral is called as PI controller, or we can say this is PI controller. Now in this case, in this integral control scheme, input signal to the plant is the combination of two signals. One is proportional to the error signal and the other is proportional to the integral of the error signal. That means we are going to have this control action as Vc of t equals to E of t plus Ki integration from 0 to t E of t dt. So this is the control action of the integral control scheme, where we are going to have the signal as input to the plant, which is the combination of two signals. One is itself the error signal and second one is the integration of error signal, and this Ki is integral constant, where Ki is integral constant. So we'll take the Laplace transform. It will give us Vc of s equals to E of s plus Ki over s E of s. So this is the control system. This is the Laplace transform of the control action. That is Vc of s equals to E of s plus Ki over s E of s. Now we will use this to compensate the uncompensated second order signal system. So it will be like this. This is E of s. So we are going to have Ki over s over here. This is E of s, you can say. So these are positive. And the output is Vc of s, which is given as input to the plant, that is omega n square over s times of s plus 2 zeta omega n. Here we have the output C of s. And finally, we have the unity feedback, or the standard second order system. So this is unity feedback. This is negative, and this will be positive. So here this is the controller. This is the PI controller where we have a proportional signal as well as the integral. So Vc of s is the combination of two signals. One is error signal and second one is the integral of error signal. So here we can write the loop transfer function of compensated system. Now the question is that in the earlier case where we have seen the derivative control system, then we have used the characteristic equation. That means we have obtained the transfer function, then we have written the characteristic equation, and then we have found that how the zeta is going to be increased. But in this case, instead of that, we are going to have the loop transfer function, because here this integral control scheme, this is going to be used for the improvement of steady state response, right? And for the steady state response, we have to see that how this ES is going to be reduced. Ultimate goal is to reduce the steady state error. That means to improve the steady state response. And we know that as we go on increasing the type of the system, we'll find that there is a decrease in the steady state error. So in this case, we are going to see that how the system type is going to change by using the application of integral control system in the second order control system. So we will write this loop transfer function and we will compare it with the earlier one, that how the system is going to change its value, its type. So GSHS is S plus Ki over S is here multiplied by, that is G of S multiplied by omega n square over s times of s plus 2 zeta omega n. This is E of s of course, this is s plus ki over s multiplied by omega n square s plus 2 zeta omega n, because this is 1 plus ki over s, so it is s plus ki over s. This particular term is this multiplied by this, so it is total G of s, and we know that H of s is 1, so GSHS is this. So here we can write this as s plus ki multiplied by omega n square divided by s square multiplied by s plus 2 zeta omega n. Now this is GSHS for compensated system. Now we write the loop transfer function of uncompensated. Loop transfer for uncompensated system is GSHS equals to omega n square over s times of s plus 2 zeta omega n multiplied by 1. Now this can be rewritten as omega n square over s plus 2 zeta omega n. And we know that the type of system is obtained from the loop transfer function by looking at the number of poles at origin. So in this case, the number of poles at origin is 1. So here we have only one pole, which is at origin. So this is having the type first. That is, this is type first standard second order system. Whereas in the compensated system, Now we have two folds at origin. So now the compensated system is type second system. That means we have changed or we have increased the type of the system by using the compensation of integral control scheme from type first to type second. That means we have reduced the steady state error. We already seen the how to change the steady state error. So for the uncompensated system, the system is of type first, and for the compensated it is type second. So we can say that there is an improvement in the steady state response because there is a change in the type, that is there is an increase in the type of the system, there will be a reduction in the steady state error. But we also have the drawback of this particular system. As we go on increasing the type, what is happening? Basically we are increasing the order of the system. Here the maximum order is 2 because s square. Here the order is s cube, that is 3. So as we increase the order of the system, we will have a complexity in the system and it is going to be unstable. Right? So that is the drawback that we have. But of course if you want to improve, we don't have any option other than to go for the integral control. But yes, there are drawbacks of this integral control, and the drawback is that the system is going to be more complex as compared to that of the derivative control of the uncompensated system. Now the third one, the system where we need to improve the transient response as well as the steady state response. That means if the task is given to improve the overall response, then in that case, instead of using the derivative or integral, we can use both the type of control system, that is derivative as well as integral control, in addition to the proportional control system, and that becomes PID control system. So the third system is a system where we can have integral as well as derivative along with the proportional. So the number 4 is PID control scheme. So in PID control scheme, we have integral as well as derivative along with the proportional control scheme. So instead of going to the theory part of the expression part, we can simply write this VC of t as a control action. This becomes E of t plus ki 0 to t E of t dt plus kd ddt of E of t. So this is the control action for PID. Here this is proportional, this is I and this is d. So that becomes PID control scheme. We will take the Laplace transform. So this will give us Vc of s equals to E of s plus Ki over s E of s plus s times of Kd E of s. So this is the control scheme, and if you draw the block diagram, it will give us this is E of s. Here we have the proportional block 1. We can use the summation sign over here. This is plus. We can have the another signal, that is Ki over s. This is given as input to this summation. Then we can have another system with the block, that is SKD. That is also given as input to this block with the summation sign. And here we have the plan, that is omega n square divided by s times of s plus 2 zeta omega n. Right? And here we have C of s. And finally, there is a unity. So this is the block diagram of PID control scheme. Once we solve this, we can have the proper justification that how the zeta is going to be increased by using the derivative control, and how the time is going to increase by using the integral control. And hence, as we have this derivative control, because of this control scheme, we will find that there is an increase in zeta, and hence we can say that MP is reduced as well as TS is reduced, and henceforth we can say that the transient response is improved. So transient response is improved with the help of this SKD. Whereas for KIS, we can say that in this case type is increased. And since the type is increased, we know that ESS is going to be reduced. That is, steady state error is going to be reduced by the increasing type, and hence it will take care of the steady state. So here, steady state response is improved. And overall, since there is an improvement in the transient response as well as steady state response, we can say the overall response is improved. overall response is improved. So that is the facility that we have in the PID control scheme. So today we have said that each and every control system is having a proportional control scheme, right? And in the proportional control scheme, we also know that the response of any system is consisting of two parts, that is transient response and the steady state response. And there may be the peak overshoots in the transient response, or it may take larger time to reach to the steady state. So for the improvement of the transient response, we need to decrease the peak overshoot as well as the settling time so that it can reach to the steady state faster. So for that, we are seeing that there are two derivative controls, that is derivative error control scheme and derivative output control scheme, which is also called as output rate control scheme or tachometer feedback control scheme, where we have seen that zeta, that is the compensated system zeta, is going to be increased by the factor of SKT by 2 and SKT by K by 2. And henceforth, since zeta is increasing, the MP and TS will reduce and there is improvement in the transient response. Whereas we have seen for the integral scheme that in this case, the error signal is integrated and that is combined with the error signal, so that in this case, the type will increase from. We have seen another example of the standard second order system, where we have seen that type for system is changed to type second system. And we know that as we go on increasing the type of the system, we'll find there is a reduced reduction or there is a change in the steady state error. That means there is a reduction in the steady state error, and the system which has less steady state error is going to be the better system. And hence, we can say that here the steady state response is going to be improved. But otherwise, along with this, we also see that as we increase the time, we will see that the order of system is also increasing. And if there is an increase in the order of system, of course, that system is going to be complex. So that is the drawback, that is the bottleneck we are going to have with the integral control scheme. But definitely, if it is required, we have no option other than to use this integral control scheme. And we are then finally saying that if we need the overall response to be improved, where we need to improve the transient response as well as the steady state response, then we will have to use derivative control and integral control in addition to the proportional control, so that we can have the system which is called as PID, that is proportional integral derivative control scheme, where we can see that the transient response and the steady state response both are going to be improved, and hence we can say that this PID scheme is going to increase the overall response of the system. Thank you.